Hey, this is Blake from the Gig Harbor Fly Shop, and today I want to answer a question that we get asked quite often, and that is, how do you pick out the right spay reel? How do you match up a spay reel on a spay rod? And so right here I have one of my favorite rods. This is a Sage X8130, so it's a 13-foot 8-weight. And many times what people do when they buy their first spay rod, maybe it's a 7-weight or 8-weight, they think that the reel they need to put on it is gonna be a 7 or 8 weight reel. Now, when we talk about the weight of a rod, it's very different in the single hand world than the two hand world. So the capacity that you need for an 8-weight spay reel is much larger than the capacity needed for a, say, a single hand 8-weight reel. The reels that we usually put on these longer rods are really heavy. That's one of the things I look for. Is a heavy reel. We like reels that balance out the rod. So we're talking about a 12 and a half, 13 foot rod, not a 9 foot rod. So those 9 footers, great to have a nice light reel on it, but with the two hander, having that long rod to help balance that thing out is absolutely great. One of the other things that I like is to have a reel that has a full cage. So that means that it's not open where the line could potentially slip through there. Many times with spay casting, we're using really thin running lines, maybe even monofilament in like 40 or 50 pound for the running line. And sometimes it can slip out of there. And so having that full cage prevents that kind of line slippage from happening. The size of reel that you're gonna put on a spay rod, so say an 8-weight spay rod, is more like maybe an 11 or 12 weight size reel for the single hand world comparison. So on a 7-weight spay rod, you might even still use that same big heavy reel, especially if it's a longer 7-weight. If it's a shorter 7-weight, if it's a 12 or 12 and a half foot rod, you can it'll be more probably like a 10-weight reel. I'm looking for a heavy reel, not only for the capacity for having really heavy, thick spay lines, with the running line that's usually 100 feet long and all that other kind of stuff. But the other part is in the cast. We're not holding the rod up and making casts like this. The casting is usually crossing our arms and pivoting, and it all kind of happens in a box that happens from, you know, our shoulders to our waist. And so having that big heavy reel helps kind of pivot the cast and kind of make things a little bit easier for us in, you know, as we're doing it. The other thing is that when I'm actually casting and swinging the fly, I usually hold the rod right up at the top of the grip or pretty close to the top of the grip. And so that heavy reel helps balance out that rod. Many times I'm just holding the rod right at my side and with my arm down if the water's shallow enough to do that. And so it's really relaxing to be able to not have to be holding the tip up or pushing the tip down. I can just kind of keep my arm right there and think about that next grab. Now, if a reel is designed for spay rods, the sizing will be a little bit different. So with the Sage spay reel, which I love this reel, it's a really classic styling, but you know, this is the 789, there's a 678, and those are not designated for single hand 678 or 789, it is for spay rods. And so if you have a 7-weight, do you go with 789 or 678? It depends on the length of the rod. So if you have a 12 and a half foot rod, that 678 is gonna be absolutely perfect. If your rod's maybe 13 and a half feet and it's a 7, that 789 might actually be the ticket. Now with switch rods, because they're shorter, the reels are generally gonna be a little bit smaller reels. Or maybe they might just be a little bit lighter to balance it out. You're still gonna need some of that capacity for having all of that line that's on there. Now, finding a reel on the market that's a full cage reel is not always easy to do. There are some reel manufacturers out there that make them, and the Sage is one example of a reel that I really like. I have several of these on rods for clients. The other one is from Lampson, and this is the Lampson Speedster HD, and this is a full cage reel. It's not a super heavy reel, so on those like 12 and a half foot rods, it really balances out really nice. We have all sorts of reels on our website that you can check out to see examples of what I'm talking about. So go to gigharborflyshop.com and check out what we have. Thanks.